in this morning. I seem to be doing a lot of things this morning. I've just put my pint jars and some hot water in my canning jar, and I've just finished peeling the papaya. I've never canned papaya, so this is going to be a first for me. And I'm going to get a spoon and take the seeds out. My canning equipment out. And this is a water bath that I'm doing. I hope this turns out. Don't know this. This is a tropical fruit that I know of. Well, I know it's a tropical fruit. I don't know if it grows in Central America or not, but I know in the West Indies because my husband brought this fruit to my attention. They say to cube this. They don't tell you what size the cubes, so I am just going to do it like this. I'm not going to make it real small because we like this fruit. I was just wondering if I could make a jam with it, you know? A preserve, well, it's fruit, you call it preserves. Might turn out quite nice. syrup and bring it to a boil. I am going to do a medium because I really don't like my fruit having that much sugar. So we're going to need 5 cups of water.
I need a measuring cup. Excuse me 1 minute. Is 5 cups. Okay.
We are gonna need 7 cups.
I will be right back. I gotta go get some more sugar. Okay, we're gonna add 7 cups of sugar, 5 cups of water. That's ridiculous. I'll be right back for another one.
I'm back. Seven cups of sugar. Gotta turn it up. And bring that to a boil. I know that.
Here, I've got many of them. They say we're going to leave a 1/2 inch head space, all right, but it says add 1 tablespoon of lemon juice to each quart jar. A pint is 1/2 quart, so I would assume 1.5 teaspoons will go into each pint jar because I'm not using a quart. Thank you.
have children and you have an old measuring ruler, pull the metal out and you can use this instead of having to buy a measurer. You make the bubblers with measures on them now, but if you don't have that and you have the old bubbler, that'll work just fine. Always sharpen my knives before I put them away, so when I pull them out, they're sharp. I don't like sharpening before I get started. I like them sharp when I pull them out. I want them to do their job. We're just waiting for the sugar and stuff and we can move on. So when we get to that point, I'll be back. Okay, the sugar water is boiling. We're gonna put the papaya in it. You want it just to sit for a couple of minutes, and then that's it. You're just heating them up. I use the medium socks syrup. I mean, I did not want the heavy one because I'm not overly fond of a ton of sugar in my desserts. I know that would be hard to believe with the desserts I make, but it's really true. Oh, let me put the lemon juice in here first. First putting a teaspoon in all of them, and then I'll move to a half a teaspoon for each of them. It's just easier. Seems they have to bring up the acid so they can be water bathed. Because in a pressure canner, it would crush them completely, I guess. Yes, you are. Okay. So I have an inch between me just there. Okay. I wonder how this would go with cottage cheese. You know, take cottage cheese and sit there and take the fruit that you've canned, put a bit of lettuce on, then put the cottage cheese on, and then put the canned fruit that you've canned. That sounds good. It's a lovely way of having your fruit. Okay. Wipe your rims off and make sure you don't drip vinegar into the jar where the food is. I'm sure I could have packed more in the jar, but the papaya was a little off on what they wanted, so. Do not press that bubble down when you're putting these lids on. That bubble will be standing up and as the air escapes and stuff, it will push it right down for you. make sure there's a good inch over your jars. You need the water to completely surround your jars. Bring that to a boil. Let's see what they want for how long.
For 15 minutes for pints, 20 minutes for quarts. So I've got pint jars, so it'll be 15 minutes as soon as that comes to a royal boil. So when it gets to that point, I'll be back.
Pour the vinegar in the pot, in the jar. The jar is clean.
Sometimes I forget that and do it secondary. Okay, you see that steam in the water canner? I'm gonna time it 15 minutes and it'll be done.
Yesterday, I had taken some papaya I had dehydrated and some orange, and I put it in 2 quarts. I poured 2 quarts of boiling water over it. I let it sit all night, and this is going to be a drink that we're going to have today with dinner, probably. Dehydrated a lot of fruit, so I just figured that I could mix it with the teas and stuff that I told you about, the red clover, the flowers, and all of those. So I dehydrated everything, and then I just sort of mix it all up together. And today I just wanted this one to be a little different, and let's get it going. Sodas, I really like this a lot better. At least I know what we're getting. And you just sweeten to taste, or if you don't want sugar, you don't have to add it. I made a boysenberry blackberry from the garden, and it came out really nice. And it was a stronger fruit drink than this one. I have some currants that I canned. And I want to squeeze them through and see about making currant juice and see how that comes out. I don't want it in this. This way I control all the sugar. But you say that's a lot of sugar. Yeah, when you do something like this, you're not going to eat all of that at one time. So it's like spread out throughout the year, you know. And you don't always have to sweeten these. If you don't, you can have them hot and plain, or you can do other things with them. And when you think about the stuff you buy in the store, you've got some corn syrup in your ketchup, you got corn syrup here, you got corn syrup there. They're not even using sugar anymore. And instant food is even worse. So that's ready for us. Done, and they'll be out to cool until tomorrow. So when they're done, I'll be back. Okay, we're taking them out now. That's how you can mangoes. No, not mangoes, papaya. Take care, bye-bye.